When was the last time Madden was great? Not good, but great. Maybe Madden 12, the last year the game had a true superstar mode, create a team, and a deep franchise mode. Maybe Madden 10, Madden 11? In my opinion, while those editions of the series were good, they weren't great. The last time EA created a truly great game was Madden 08 on PlayStation 2, original Xbox, and the Nintendo GameCube. From Madden 2004 to Madden 08, EA Tiburon was onto something great. Unfortunately, with each console transition came difficulties carrying over the features and game modes that made Madden special, and the introduction of Ultimate Team eventually shifted EA's focus and changed the direction they decided to take the series. We will, however, always have those few years of greatness, with Madden 08 being the last great Madden. As a kid, I probably put more hours into this game than any game I owned. Yes, even NFL 2K5, which I consider to be the greatest football video game ever made. The gameplay was an improved version of Madden 05's, the game had more game modes than I had ever seen in a football game, and the depth of franchise mode was deeper than we had ever seen at the time, and still deeper than anything we've gotten since. Madden 08 was the last Nintendo GameCube game released in North America. As a kid whose only console was a GameCube for a long time, this was my game. Today, thanks to Dolphin Emulator and the power of modern computers, I can now play the game in 4K at a constant 60 frames per second. The PC version of the game is updated with roster and graphics mods every year, including new uniforms and stadiums. But what made this game great? The foundation Madden had built on the sixth generation of consoles was incredible. The depth, gameplay, visuals, and attention to detail was phenomenal. Madden 2005 added the hit stick, 06 added the truck stick, and the controversial vision cone. 07 updated Superstar mode, added a college all-star game and player roles to franchise mode. And 08 took all of that, added player weapons, new game modes, new gang tackling animations, and minor updates around the board. This led to the creation of the definitive version of Madden. Right off the bat, Franchise Mode is the first game mode shown to the player. In my opinion, Madden 08 has the greatest franchise mode of any Madden ever. I could see a case for 07 because it still had the Tony Bruno show, but the addition of player weapons made 08's better in my opinion. You could import a created team to start or choose any NFL team, including multiple teams if you wanted, and start in training camp, upgrading your players in the offseason by performing drills. What I found cool about these older Maddens is that during practice, the players actually wore practice jerseys and shorts. In newer Maddens, they practiced in their full game day uniform, which doesn't make any sense to me. Training camp is something completely missing in newer Maddens. I always play training camp to try out my new players and begin developing them. The drills were super fun too. Preseason was immersive thanks to position battles, where the game would show you projected starters and players that were breathing down their necks based on their preseason performances. Before each game, you could study your opponent, which showed you in-depth scouting reports for every single starter on the opposing team, along with game plans and how to stop them. Your coordinators would show you what plays that team calls most frequently, allowing the user to practice plays to counter them. Speaking of coordinators, the game featured licensed offensive, defensive, and special teams coordinators that you could hire. You had to choose carefully, as better coordinators costed more money, but would also develop your players quicker. You could also promote coordinators to head coach if your head coach retired or just wasn't getting the job done. After each week, you could check the national or local newspaper for news on your team or the entire NFL. You had emails to check, where your GM would give you a heads up about expiring contracts, players would ask you for more playing time, the equipment manager would give you the inside scoop on what's going down in the locker room, and more. After mid-season, you could check Pro Bowl voting weekly and see who's at the edge of making it. This could encourage you to feed a player on the brink of making it. You could even play the Pro Bowl, a feature that Madden 20 thinks is new for some reason. Stat tracking was much more in-depth back then. If you clicked on a player's career stats, you could actually see what team they played for. This is something that's been missing since Madden 13, and I have no idea why. It kills any immersion. I love signing a player and seeing where he came from. Do we play his former team this year? What team did he have his best season on? If I'm 5 years deep into a franchise and most players are computer generated, I need to see what team the players came from. I want a backstory. I have no idea why this isn't in Madden anymore. It's been on the back of football trading cards for decades. Anyways, if you built a great team, you could actually export it as a file, allowing you to use that team in a new franchise, share it with your friends, or use it in other game modes like Play Now or Tournament. Whenever I build a Super Bowl winning team, I export the team, so I can go back to the glory days after a few seasons when I'm in cap trouble and have to make some difficult cuts. As an owner, you could set prices on anything, from hot dogs to parking spots to advertising on TV. The graphs and charts given to you to see statistics on fan expectations, attendance, income, expenses, and more were so fleshed out in detail. You felt like a real NFL owner. Players and coach retirements had their own dedicated screen that you had to click on during the offseason, meaning you couldn't miss it. Upgrading your stadium allowed you to actually modify every little section in detail. Relocation was incredible. Players had morale and would hold out if they were unhappy or wanted more money. Others would refuse to re-sign due to decisions you made that they didn't like, such as cutting a star player or giving an undeserving player captain status. Player roles played an important part. Some players, such as Jamarcus Russell, would become a draft bust after a few seasons of not getting to an 80 overall. Players could get injury-prone roles, first-round pick status, etc. These roles all affected development, morale, and how much money they asked for when contract time rolled around. A new feature to 08 was player weapons, which were traits given to star players that made them stand out compared to average players. Cannon arm, scrambler, power back, run blocker, heavy hitters, containment corners, etc. Sound familiar? You could see these weapons on the field each play to help find mismatches and know when you need to motion the tight end to help block a star pass rusher, or move your containment corner to the opponent's best receiver. Simulated stats were realistic. Mike Vick, or any quarterback with the scrambler weapon and a good offensive line, would rush for around 1,000 yards. In newer Maddens, players like Cam Newton and Lamar Jackson rush for 30 yards on the year when simulated. Free agency was something the user had control over. Mid-season, you could sign a free agent to a contract of any length, not a set amount on a one-year deal like in new Maddens. You could go through restricted free agency. Scouting players was more than just a few clicks. You could schedule individual workouts with rookie prospects in Indianapolis at the Scouting Combine, which would unlock details about their skills, projections to the next level, injury history, and more. You could play in the EA College All-Star Game, which was basically an unlicensed Senior Bowl. I get so sad playing this game because of how deep it is compared to what we have now. Imagine what kind of game we could have had today if EA actually built upon what they created instead of tearing it down. This game was so good that EA is still, to this day, unable to make a game close to it. 12 years later. I don't understand how anyone can praise Modern Madden's franchise mode when we had a better and deeper one 12 years ago. It baffles me. 08 had NFL Superstar Hall of Fame mode, which was a career mode where you created a player, chose any position, and were given a set amount of attribute points to give to whichever skills you wanted. You'd see a cutscene about making it to the NFL Hall of Fame, and your career would begin. You'd be in your apartment. You could get tattoos at the tattoo parlor, get haircuts at the barbershop, study your playbook, get hired to act in movies, and live the life of an NFL star on and off the field. You'd sign an agent, go through the scouting combine, get drafted, and begin your career. Once again, the depth here is still unrivaled by modern football games. When Madden moved to the next gen of consoles, a lot of this depth was removed. When it moved to current gen, almost all of it was removed. A new game mode added to this game was Fantasy Challenge. In this mode, you built a team of current and former NFL legends. Sort of like Ultimate Team, only offline and no microtransactions. Kind of like All-Pro Football 2K8's team building aspect. You would enter a league as a low-tier team, and by winning games, you can actually move up tiers and start playing more difficult competition. Some of these harder teams had magical abilities. For example, one team you play against, every time you juke, you fumble immediately. Other teams get 5 downs, some can't throw interceptions, etc. It was actually quite deep and really fun if you just want to play something more video gamey. Speaking of magic abilities, you could actually collect Madden cards by earning points playing the game. You collected cards of NFL players, which you could use in different game modes for temporary attribute boosts. But the coolest part of Madden cards were the cheat cards. One cheat called Workers' Comp awards you points based on how many times you can injure a player on the other team. The more severe the injury, the more points you get. That is insane! Other cards let you control the wind when your opponent kicks a field goal, make the refs spot the ball 2 yards short for a quarter, give you first and five for a half, and more. These were a blast to use with friends when playing each other on the couch. You just don't see this kind of thing in sports games these days. You had mini camps like the ones you'd find in training camp available to play from the main menu, as well as the new skill drills mode, where you attempted different drills against massive robots. It was weird, but awesome. Situation mode was one I played a lot. Create a scenario, jump into the game, loved practicing epic comebacks or recreating classic NFL moments. This used to be in Madden, 2K, all the football games. Where did it go? Tournament mode lets you create a Sweet 16 bracket and play through it, completely customizable. You could even import created teams, meaning you could recreate a league like the AAF or the new XFL and play an 8-team tournament. Speaking of create a team, this has to be my favorite feature. As a somewhat creative dude, I loved creating my own teams. Names I wanted, colors I wanted, jerseys I wanted, stadiums I wanted, etc. You could customize everything from the face mask color to the end zone art in your stadium. It was awesome. You could also choose the skill level of the generated players added to your team. I loved creating a horrible team by choosing a cupcake roster, and then taking that team into franchise mode and trying to build them into a contender. I would sometimes create one overpowered player to lead the team, such as a 99 overall, 400 pound, 7 foot tall quarterback who could run. It was awesome! You also had historic teams that had player likenesses. You just had to edit in the names, similar to an NCAA game. In Play Now, you could even play as NFL Europe teams. When creating a player, you could give them mouth guards. I don't know how they did that, considering Madden has been missing mouth guards for a decade now. I guess the PS2 had technology that's better than what the PS4 has. If you can't already tell, I hate what EA Sports has become. You could create a fan. It was such a small, useless feature, but I loved it. It was just so extra. Make a fan look however you want for any team, and he would actually show up in your stadium, and you could see him celebrate when you score. How long is this video so far? We haven't even gotten to gameplay yet. That's how deep this game was. That's why all these years later, I'm still not bored of Madden 08. It blows my mind how deep of a game Madden was in 2007, and how in 2019, we aren't even close to this. Gameplay was the best of Madden 05, 06, and 07, combined with some new animations and features. You could control a lead blocker on a run play and make that perfect block to set your running back up on a big run. Gameplay was buttery smooth. Linebackers had realistic verticals, the intermediate passing game was realistic, running the ball was smooth and fun, and the truck stick added a counter to the hit stick. Running through a safety with Brandon Jacobs felt mean. You could feel the speed of Dante Hall. Player weapons played a big role as well, as star players actually felt like stars. The vision cone was optional, but I honestly think it was a great feature. Many people criticized it for making the game too difficult, but I felt like it added realism. It made it much more difficult to play with low overall quarterbacks, as you could only throw an accurate pass if the cone was highlighting the receiver. Good quarterbacks had wider cones. This made it so you couldn't easily tear it up with a 70 overall quarterback. Another thing I always liked about this game was that you could move defensive linemen off the line of scrimmage. You can't do that anymore. Sometimes I want to move OCU Manure into coverage. Why? Because it's fun. Make a big hit, and you could expect to see helmets pop off of players. If a player injured his arm, you would see him holding it. If he injured his legs, you'd see him attempt to walk off the field, sometimes unsuccessfully. Players would play according to their ratings. John Madden and Al Michaels gave commentary that I've always loved. Gang tackling animations were present, and the game lacked any awful glitches or bugs you might see in modern sports games. It was polished and perfected. It always felt like more of an arcade game than 2K football to me, but that's okay. That's what Madden was, and it was fantastic at it. Anyone who played Madden from 04 to 08 knows what I'm talking about. The way players ran just felt real. The fluidity, the controls, the physics, the animations, it still feels great. To everyone who played this game on GameCube, how did you hold the controller? I personally always held it like this on passing plays. And on running plays, or after I made a catch on a passing play, I would switch to this position, so I could sprint with A and also use the highlight stick. Am I the only one who did this? The rosters were amazing this year. Adrian Peterson's rookie season, Breeze and Reggie Bush on the Saints, Brady and Moss on the Patriots the year they went 16-0, and then lost to Eli Manning, David Tyree, Justin Tuck, Michael Strahan, and the Giants. The Colts had prime Peyton, Marvin Harrison, and Reggie Wayne. This was Vic's last season on the Falcons. There were so many fun teams to play with. I still play Madden 08 to this day. This is my Madden of choice. I just can't get enough of it. All these years later and I don't get bored. There is just too much to do in the game. Too much depth, and that's amazing. My friends think I'm weird for playing such an old game, and I don't blame them. You'd expect a franchise to improve over a decade. But for some reason that hasn't been the case, and EA has mostly gotten away with it. It was truly the last time Madden was a great game. Before Ultimate Team, before microtransactions, before Madden 13 stripped away all the great features in franchise mode, before real player motion, that abomination, back when there was competition on the market, EA Tiburon created a game that has aged fantastically. Every few days I will open up Dolphin Emulator, plug in my GameCube to USB adapter, and have a blast playing my favorite Madden in 4K. No Madden has given me the satisfaction 08 has since. Whether I'm playing through Superstar mode, or starting a franchise with a created team, or trying to move up tiers in Fantasy Challenge mode, or even enjoying a quick game of Play Now with a friend, while abusing cheats and creating extreme chaos. The important thing is that I had fun, and I had a lot of ways to have fun. Since Ultimate Team rolled around, and EA started removing more features than they added, I've been sticking with Madden 08. Until another company gets the NFL license and either makes a better game than EA, or the competition causes EA to get their act together and make the game they are capable of with the budget they have and the modern technology they have, I'll likely be playing Madden 08 for the next decade as well. And that's fine, because with the gameplay and depth this game has to offer, I'll be busy for a lifetime. Madden 08 was a great game. The last time Madden was great, and likely the last time Madden ever will be great.